Welcome to Mindful Drawing. I'm Robert, and I'll be your guide on this meditation practice that enters a space of mindfulness through the act of drawing. This week, as we get on into fall, mid to late October, we'll use some of that changing world out there, if you're somewhere where the seasons apply, that the branches begin to show, the leaves begin to change and fall. We get a reminder through the smells, the sensation of things slowly drying, preparing for a sleep in the winter, or maybe the expression of others, the pine trees becoming more prevalent, more green as the deciduous trees lose a little bit of their leaves and start to reveal the structure behind them. Our meditation will be on the branch, the extension out, the resistance of gravity, the holding for a time, the leaves or needles that reach to the sun, and then the waiting for the breeze, the being present, the suspended nature of those fibers, just floating out there in space, something light, but also dynamic in its resistance to gravity, a thing we can try to capture through the drawing and through our imagination. We've all seen some form of branch or leaf, whether it's a plant in your house, a tree outside, a forest, or an imagination from some other drawing or picture you've seen. Bring that into the mind will guide us, and we'll see where the drawing goes. What we're drawing here doesn't have to look like anything real or anything specific. You can play, maneuver, manipulate, change species, change type, change form, or find a flow and consistency that brings a plausibility to the element on the page and letting you enter into its environment. Part of what we'll focus on in our meditation and our presence is the movement of the hand and the forming of that stroke. So choose what you'd like to work with. Anything will be just fine for the exercise. I'm going to use just a felt tip pen, something that lets me do quick, light, gestural strokes, bring slowly in more and more darkness, more and more separation between foreground and background, finer and finer details and density. I like to work with pen, and so that'll help me kind of express and guide there. And anything should work just fine. If you're comfortable with it and can move around and make a few lines and curves, it'll be perfect for the exercise. So go ahead and gather your supplies, establish your space, and let's draw together. A little bit of that translation of defying gravity, the growth out, hanging from the branch, and see where it leads. But to get a sense of it started, you might pick one part of a page and just think what first comes to mind. Maybe a little twig heading off into space, something light and formed by the ink. Maybe something hanging out into the page. A simple line can get it started. Give it a bit of thickness as we go in the drawing. First, think about some branching. Maybe something like the old water binding stick. Just a moment of branch within a larger piece. Or even something extending out from the trunk. I think for the exercise, I'll slowly work into details, but things could stay kind of gestural in the motion of forming, or become more a searching for texture. And as you start to see this, and with an idea of branch, to fully start to form out something in the mind's eye. The branch extends, lifts and folds a little bit with gravity, has some thickness that generally tapers out from a base. It has splits and branches along its path. Something formed. That branch comes from somewhere off the edge of the page, disappears, or we see just a part of something it extends from. You begin to think
of a composition with a few diagonals reaching here or there, strong side and open side. And we'll have space for working into from the branch. Smaller extensions may come out. For instance, just hold a leaf. Sitting there in space, we'll have a little strange mutant tree, and some extension may hold soft needles, feathering out to hit the sun. Or perhaps it's less a tree and more a plant. And the branch extends out and forms little fruits or flowers. And in the warm-up time, just thinking through what comes to mind as you hold an idea of that branching structure in the mind, where you might want to go with these pieces. Testing a few out. Different shapes or profiles, different scales or contexts. Doesn't have to be real, doesn't have to look like something specific that you know. Just make a leaf shape or a stick shape or a needle shape or a flower shape. We'll see where it develops into. Feel free to do some weird hybrid of many things or just let one consistent idea come to mind. As we prepare in our space, taking a couple of breaths, feeling out the paper underneath there, feeling out the sense of the page, thinking about those early sketches, maybe they're nearby, or just envision and how they might fill that territory of the empty rectangle, something sprouting up, something growing across, something through the center or to a side, using the time before the first mark to take a few breaths, see the space, see and use the hand in the space to get a picture of composition. Maybe let the eyes close a little bit and see if that picture can build out more scene. No worries if it can't. I'm just gonna start drawing and the scene will form, but something coming to mind may help guide places to look in the details. And then to feel ready, finding that starting point, the place where a branch drifts off from its first trajectory and starts to form something new. The first light edge, top or bottom, reaching out across the page and forming that shape of line. From where that first line goes, again, give it a little thickness down. The profile edge, seeing a little bit of light with the pen or pencil, staying close to parallel, with each side a little different as it grows in a dynamic environment, working along the line somewhere maybe a slight extension out happens, or it's smooth for now, and we fill it in later, coming not quite to a point, but ending somewhere where it keeps growing. With the beginning of the page established, considering where it attaches, can just float, could extend off the page. I think I'll do is bring it into a larger trunk, little widening at the base, extending down, using the pen or pencil to kind of search the natural thing, the plant, tree, having a bit of an organic texture, can begin to layer lines, let them help shape how we see something round, connect to something round again. Bits slipping behind, framing out the side of the page or a place. Or if it doesn't end into a tree, it may close off the broken end, the change in how we see it. It's something here to ground it, to hold it, to search a little bit farther into that image, deeper into what we see. Branch held now against gravity, against movement, except the light sway. And we can work our way out along that branch. Everything getting a bit lighter the farther we go, but maybe the lighterness of leaves gradually getting more intense. Closer to the base, a few moments or something. Branches again. Branches out. Light lines or curves at first. Just even the one profile to feel out where it is. If you're using pen like me, things may start to overlap. All of those will hide into the textures, into the drawing. So anywhere you feel to add something, feel free, whether it's cleanly cinched in or has to extend over the top for now. As you start to play for a little while and add a few more sprigs and extensions out into that space, now the branch bare. And slowly we'll bring more to it. Some come in front, some in the back. Maybe just a little more extension out into the page. Things can be loose. The suggestion of an edge or line, or if you have some experience with it or some interest, slowly becoming more real looking, all up to you in the drawing. Even just single lines will work just fine. And with a few extensions there, suggesting places for things to begin to work down in that a fractal division, a branch to a branch to a branch, to a stem that branches, to something at the end, a leaf full of branches, or a complex branch of needles. I think I'll start to bring some leaves off my initial branch, looking like more of a deciduous tree. I'm finding a few places along for just a light line, barely any thickness, just the thickness of gesture, of suggestion. Think of how those leaves form for you. I see a small extension out, splitting, spreading to gather light, and eventually the leaf shape heading off into space. Corrugations or smooth edges, something specific that may come to mind, maple or oak, pine, or just a suggestion of leaf. This creative act doing its own thing to express that opening, unfurling, gathering and collecting. And each one can be kind of fun, playful, gestural. their orientation and direction always changing. It's a natural setup, so it may bend and twist. They all come out perfect for where they are. Sometimes they face away, sometimes they face close. And that begins to emerge visually as we see it on the paper. Don't worry how it starts, you see where it goes. Some will be in front, some behind. And as they get a few in place, may start to have a bit of a rhythm. Each leaf the same, but slightly different. And in that rhythm, we can begin to spend some time observing the act of forming those elements onto the page. Noticing where we might start new interfaces, noticing where things look in front or behind, where things look close or far. The first one, the beginning, the start, the ones after that, filling in their own empty space or in front or behind, using the opening of the eyes, the opening of the imagination to guide each repeated subsequent step, little build in complexity and density. And when you're ready to start your next leaf or branch, taking a good deep breath to center, trying to bring it a little into the mind, and then forming it with attention on the page, noticing the strokes. How are you drawn to draw? Quick swipes or gestures, clean, smooth curves, whatever it happens to be for you today. Take a breath in that space. Listen to the exhale of each cycle. Not necessarily aligned with any specific action, but a reminder through the sound to listen in. With the cue of the exhale, can you hear the marks of the pencil? Form, the gesture of the curve, comes both with the tactile sensation to the hand, the visual sensation of seeing something express and emerge there, and also that auditory sensation of the texture of the paper interacting with the device, pen and the pencil. Giving yourself a little space to become mindful to that full interaction. Maybe even begin to guide that expression, the sound perhaps becoming a part of the way of drawing. Again, the character may be unique to yours, smooth, fast, slow, gestural, or precise. And every round of our interaction, You notice again that exhalation from somewhere, not guided by us, but present. Maybe a moment to pause and see, to pause and reflect. Maybe just a reminder of our presence here. Breath and expression of our engagement, intensity, your attitude. The breath and expression of our bodies, tempo, perhaps need for oxygen. Always present, always there, doing what it needs. And we hear it from time to time, that whoosh. Give us a moment of pause in its presence. The moment of being just there. Into feeling the movement of the hands. Moment of seeing our effect outward onto the paper. It's the moment of release. The end of that cycle, the exhalation. That thing being there, like the branch, like the extension, the tree in space. Always growing, always collecting, absorbing the sun, converting to energy. Sometimes just holding, steady, conserving, waiting for the next cycle to take place. We find that in ourselves, in the breathing, in the interaction with the page. Always present. Drifted. Move from time to time by the swaying. Listening, the rustle and the sounds around us. We provide the occasional breeze to notice, to cool off, warm up. Change in atmosphere coming from within. In time of great focus, of being in this construction of a thing, of the drawing, working on something. And occasionally having that presence that we are also here. Feeling the breath. Shape us, shape our interaction. Is it fast or slow? Steady or erratic? Heavy or light? And as we take a little time to draw, just quietly filling out more to the world of the branches, the foliation, the texture, wherever you would like to bring some time. There's plenty to go, the endlessly growing elements. Try to guide that cycle of the breath, just a start with every new beginning. The breath in, and then following the waves of it out as you work in one place, and rejoining towards the end of a cycle. That deliberate inhalation, presence, finding, and exhalation on the next series of movements. See where it finds the guiding tempo. And draw for a bit. And it being mid-fall here in the East Coast, not a bad time to maybe take some inspiration from the drawing and combine it with a little inspiration from out there. Nice time to look at the change. The branches beginning to reveal themselves a little bit as the leaves fall. Chance to look maybe with open eyes at the elements provided, the leaves to the ground, shared something to pick up, examine. Part of drawing things is having a repertoire of behaviors, images of structures and connections that guide the mind and make up many and anything through an abstract interface, or use a more representational model. Let them begin to combine in the imagination to find things real and unreal, plausible, to open up that new world of creativity and expression, depending on your interests and styles. Keep looking around, letting things feed in, sketch, capture, listen, and then see what they translate to through the remembering and imagining of them. A few breaths just to bring the exercise to a close, maybe. Stretch out the shoulders with a little bit of a circle to the back. Feel them reset, depending on your position. They may have lost a little of their evenness. Roll them a little bit forward, just to keep it balanced. And maybe just move everything around to what feels good in the trunk. Fill out some space, let everything expand and contract together, and then release. Into a nice breath as you bring your exercise to the close. Prepare to go on to the rest of your day. You never really know where the drawing will go. Some of those images you bring to mind in the beginning, in the warm-up,
or just in the imagination before starting, give us a place to enter. They open the door, we follow them for a while, and then we're just there. The world unfolds, opportunities present themselves, things look different than we thought. New things emerge, we go with the flow of the drawing, and part of the exercise is opening up that flow. Being present with it and having the cues of the body. The inhalation, the whoosh of the exhalation at moments to bring our presence here and now. Focus to what we are doing, making curves and lines, expressing, branching, drawing a few leaves, separating foreground and background, and framing composition with the page, all happening with our eyes, with our senses, with our presence here in this act of mindful drawing. If you enjoy the exercise, please give it a thumbs up below. Let me know in the comments what kind of tree expression or branching structure you found here. Does it reflect your imagination, or does it take you somewhere new? And if you like the practice of mindful drawing, there's new episodes usually every Wednesday morning here on YouTube. Feel free to subscribe, tune in, and find your own expression through this act of mindfulness and creativity. This is Robert signing off. Draw well.